Hey, it's Dan. Welcome back. You're watching iAllegedly. And I've got a good one for you today. Out in Newport Beach in the Back Bay. And listen, guys, with all this news, you know, you need to take a look at this and really take this in and make your own decision, because I don't think this is good myself. So there's a lot to cover today. Please don't forget to hit the like button. Please subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell notification. We have an email list below that you can sign up for. And today we have a sponsor, ZenZ, which I will talk about a little bit later. But let's get into it. First things first, guys, with all the banking debacle that's happened over the course of the last 10 days, we have seen banks now that want to be put on the list to get bailed out. This is Looneyville, guys. We've ran our business inappropriately and made a bunch of bad decisions, and we want you, the taxpayers, to bail us out, because it's not the Fed, it's our money, guys, that's going to be used to do this. And we have a big week in the economy right now. You've got the Fed meeting, and they're going to raise rates or not going to raise rates. It's going to be half a point. It's going to be, you know, a quarter of a point. It's going to go up, guys. If they don't raise rates, all hell is going to break loose. That's it. If they go half a point, all hell is going to break loose. If you think that this is good for the economy and they're going to make it, regardless of what they do, they're going to try to make it good. They're going to try to make the stock market positive, you know, any way that they can. But what's realistic about this is that it's not good. Things are not good in the economy right now. And, you know, one thing I got a kick out of this week was Lennar Homes did their numbers, and it kind of went under the radar screen because, you know, last quarter they made $1 billion. This quarter they made, you know, only 900 million. But what was fascinating was the houses on the books. Think about this. It went down 29%, guys. They only have 19,000 unsold homes that are in construction right now. Who bought those homes when, you know, they only sold 14,000 houses? So it's kind of crazy. You can sit there and say, oh, everybody's buying a house, right? No, no way. They had to have had a huge sale to somebody that purchased all this property. They had to have. There's no other way around it. So we don't know the answer to that yet, but there's that right now. So the home builders are getting creative. It is movie land right now, where they're getting more creative than Spielberg, because you're seeing everything being done to put you into a home, from free cars to discounts on the interest rates to a little bit of everything right now. Now, if you want to buy one of these houses, go do it. I think you're buying an asset that's going to go down substantially in value. That's just me. This is the Back Bay over here. That's a beautiful area. You can walk around. But with that being said, guys, the banking situation, UBS, it looks like they're going to buy Credit Suisse right now for a couple $100 billion. Okay, nice. Or $2 billion, pardon me, I said a couple $100 billion. For $2 billion. Great. Credit Suisse has been in trouble for years, guys. Years. And the mid-sized banks, you know, guys, not everybody's in bad shape. I have to give people credit. I have had so many people write me that have gone to their credit unions and say, hey, I want to see the financial statements. Now it's over a dozen people have written me and gotten detailed explanations as far as the financial situation of their credit union. It's good. It's your money, guys. You don't have to worry about the federal credit union, guys. I really don't see PenFed and places like that going out. You really need to look at the smaller ones. And the smaller ones that have made great decisions, and you have employees at some of these places that have been there 15 and 20 years that have been rock solid. But what I recommend is that you have a multiple different banks that are not associated with each other right now. Because if they do consolidation, this is going to be a problem. The people out there that don't want to admit that FedCoin is coming, you're kidding yourself. And then I've had half a dozen people write me and say, why would it be such a bad thing if the Fed issued a digital dollar? Well, let me explain it to you. When we were all locked in our homes, we couldn't leave. Imagine if they could do that with the click of a mouse, guys. And you don't get it. They're going to track every single purchase that you do. And people go, why would they do that? Well, they're going to do that. They're going to know exactly everything that you buy. And you can say they do that now. No, they don't know that now. You can pay cash for things. You can go and purchase things without them knowing. You can use a credit card or a debit card. You can use different credit cards for different things. You know, I was at a meal a couple weeks ago where a guy used two different credit cards from two different banks because of his expense account and how he had to bill it. Okay, whatever. Imagine not being able to do that. And being able to shut gas up. We don't want you to drive here because of the fire. Well, I want to go back to my house now. I want to get to my house now and get my mother's pictures now. No, can't go back there. Can't buy gas in that area. You don't think that that's going to happen? You guys are kidding yourself right now. Absolutely kidding yourself. This banking debacle that we are living through right now is affecting everybody, and it's only going to get worse right now. Remember that. We are living through such wild times right now. This is beautiful back here. Airport's behind me, so you're gonna hear jets every now and then. It'll be fun, but really nice. They've got all these different walkways. The Orange County Marathon runs through here, and they do that, I think it's every May, that one gets done. Just beautiful. You got the waterways down there and things like that. Just a cool spot to go through. So, you can bring your dog out here and stuff like that. One other thing I'm doing today is I'm gonna do, give you guys some information on two stories that we've already covered over the last 2 weeks and give you updates on it because they're fascinating. So, there's a lot more to cover today. Let's talk about our sponsor, ZenZ from BioTrust. You know, it is anticipated that 164 million Americans suffer from not getting a good night's sleep. And one thing that I tried was ZenZ from BioTrust. It's absolutely amazing. 7 premium ingredients that help you get a full night's sleep, restorative rest that is just relaxing. And I've tried different things in the past. And with my hectic lifestyle, I always need something that's gonna help me, and melatonin just didn't cover it. This is amazing. And when I talked about it a couple weeks ago, I had friends that say, hey, does that stuff work? And I let my friends try it, and they were like, this is amazing. So 7 premium ingredients. These nutrients are all put into one capsule that help you get a good night's sleep. Go to dansleepsgood.com, dansleepsgood.com. Check out their website, and it will give you a night's good night's sleep. But 51% off their regular price for iAllegedly viewers. And guys, this stuff works, okay? I'm really glad that I tried this. ZenZ from BioTrust helps me get a full night's sleep, and you should try it too. But get the savings, get the 51%. Go to dansleepsgood.com. I love to hear turmoil in big companies. I enjoy it very much. Let's start with Disney. Disney's gonna lay off 4,000 people. Good, okay? But it's not just at the parks, it's at their media companies. ESPN, Disney Plus, the Disney Channel, all that stuff. Big problems with Disney right now. And they're having nothing but issues with who's going to get laid off and how many people, and they're asking supervisors to kick opinions in. And well, I can't get rid of my team. My team's more important than the other teams, blah, blah, blah. No, you're going to see lots of people get laid off. And remember, guys, the economy is great. Everything is good. There's no issue. Now, one step further, Facebook, Meta, all these employees that have access to Mark Zuckerberg are furious now. And there's a great article below talking about how we're sick of this. We're sick of the metaverse, and you made this huge gamble on the metaverse that's not working right now, and people aren't into it. How about the jackass that spent $400,000 to live next to Snoop Dogg in the metaverse? Okay, $450 or whatever it was. To live in a fictional house in a video game to live next to Snoop Dogg. You know, do you get to smell the weed through the computer? I mean, come on, it's just insane. It's nuts that this is what this has come to, okay? More and more people are being forced out. Disney is doing something that we've seen in the past that is horrible. Tell us who needs to go. Make a list of the bad employees. The problem with this is that Janet in accounting, who's always hated you because you complained about X, Y, and Z, is gonna make sure that you're on that list. This is a popularity contest for these big companies, and it's a horrible way to get rid of people. It has nothing to do with performance, has nothing to do with anything other than who do you like? Who should we get rid of? Who should we cut loose? Okay? And you're going to dramatically affect people's lives. You know, Stacy's always been so pretty and she has all those clothes. Get rid of her. Yeah, she's done. Okay? Mike Rowe, you know, Dirty Jobs, that guy, great guy. That guy went out and did a story that is absolutely fascinating, that there are 7 million men, 7 million, that are not working right now. They're not looking for work. They're not doing anything. During the health crisis, these people were incentivized not to work and were paid more money than to do their jobs. So why would they go look for a new job? Just waiting for that day to come when the government's going to give them money. Now, you guys can think FedCoin's going to do that and you're going to get $1,500 a week. You are sniffing glue because it's not going to happen. And it is pathetic that you have men that don't know how to take care of themselves right now. You know, my dad, God love him, you know, the guy had us do things for his business that were awful. Digging holes, pouring wire, going door to door, the worst job in the world. And I told my friends about this last weekend, of the worst things that were said to me in my life were knocking on those doors at 14 years old, trying to get people to sign up to get an estimate on a home improvement. And they swore at me and they said awful things. And it was just dangerous, to say the least, but taught me how to talk to people. But here's the other thing, I can fix my car. You know how many grown men cannot jump a car right now? How about that? Ladies, you're on a date and your car breaks down and you need to jump start. And you've got some idiot who doesn't know which end is what with the jumper cables. How about that? That's what we're living through right now, guys. We're living through men that are not men. They're not even boys. They're just children that need to be taken care of. This is pathetic right now that this is where this has come to in our lifetimes. So 7 million men between the ages of 25 and 50 that are not looking for a job right now. That's horrible, guys. Absolutely horrible. You know, during the health crisis, right before it started, you had a lot of medical companies, medical sales companies. Dan, we are sick of the kids. We're done. We want the older people. Now, what they did 2017, 2018, 2019, first half of 2019, was they thought, why would we pay this old guy $150,000 a year when we could get $40,000 a year people and pay them less and get more performance? Only problem was they paid people more, these kids, and didn't get the performance. So they started to go back to the older people right when the health crisis hit. They showed up at my last conference and they were like, this is what we're gonna do. And it was fascinating, guys, absolutely amazing. But then all hell broke loose and you guys know what happened from there. Artificial intelligence is changing everything that we do right now. It is changing development of websites. It's changing writing, poetry, stories, letters, everything right now. It is absolutely fascinating what's happening with this, because you can basically go to ChatGPT and have it design a website for you. Hey, design a Yankees website for me, and it'll do it. It'll do it in minutes for you. But, you know, I want a website for my company, and this thing will set it up and do that for you in minutes. Absolutely amazing. What it's going to do is put people out of work during this time, because it's going to eventually be attached to the internet and collect news and data and things like that, because they say ChatGPT is, you know, all built into itself and doesn't have internet access, which I don't believe at all, but that's just me because of the stuff it spits out. Everything that we are living through is a perfect example of how we need to have better communication. We need to have transparency in everything. Everybody I've talked to over the course of the last week, my friends from high school, talking about budgeting and talking about money and everything like that. It's just really simple. And I showed them, like, oh, I don't want to sign up for anything, Dan. I don't want any programs. I pulled out a piece of paper. We're talking about budgets on a piece of paper and how simple it is to write everything down and then cross it off. Okay? It's the greatest thing ever. You know? It really is. And it's very productive doing it that way. But people need to take control of their own finances, just like they need to take control of their own families, their own health, their work, everything. Man, I'm telling you, we are living through such a weird time right now because there's no accountability for anything from anybody right now. Okay? It's just terrible. You will see housing prices drop during this time. The Lennar shenanigans, they can sit there and kind of go, wow, we got through that one. Everybody thinks it's good. It's not. Nobody believes this. Nobody believes that everything is looking up when it comes to real estate right now, because you're seeing areas that are getting decimated. Texas right now, Texas has got real problems when it comes to property sales right now. Realtors here in this beautiful area on the Back Bay where the house is falling off the cliff, and I'll cover that a little bit for you. This area, you're seeing houses sit on the market 6 months now. When they, in 6 days, you would have 25 offers before. Done, finished, okay? You know what, let's jump up to that house. Let me show you that right now. Well, guys, I wanted to give you an update on another story. 2 weeks ago, I was out here in Newport Beach on Galaxy Drive talking about the house that was falling, you know, off the hillside. And there's been a major update. County Supervisor Katrina Foley, she came out and checked out the house and surveyed it, and they determined they were going to rip the house down. Wow. Okay. The house is on the other side of it, still yellow tagged, but they're saying that as it's raining right now, that there could be 50 houses in jeopardy. 50. Now the house, 1930 Galaxy Way, they tore it down, guys. Isn't that crazy? Leveled it, guys. Goodbye. Completely done. Now, guys, the fire department was very helpful and explained to me, you know, the severity of this house and does it affect the other two on the other side. And because of the way the hillside is giving away, you know, it has nothing to do with the fire department, but they just don't want anybody going back here. And they have to seal off the house. They have to shut it down. They have to make sure that people don't have access to this. So can't go in the backyard. The hillside's gone. And you don't know. I mean, where I'm standing could be dangerous right now, guys. So you just don't even know, you know, how bad this could be.
Isn't this wild? This was a $3.5 million house. Not anymore. So completely leveled it, trying to dry out the hill, trying to pump stuff out. But man, it looks real small from here. But because of the landslide, it's considered unsafe, so they ripped it down. Now, the crazy thing about this is that they say that there could be 50 houses in jeopardy, which could total well over $250 million in real estate. Unbelievable, guys. So these poor people put so much money into their house and now just locked up, you know, yellow tagged, can't get into it. But trying to pump everything out, get rid of all the water. See the water coming out? It's devastating, guys. Absolutely devastating. So major problem here, but this is just the beginning of this. It's going to get much worse. So just wanted to give you guys the update. I'll go to the other side, but just terrible. Completely done, guys. So there's houses on this street that are $9 million, $9 million. Whether they're worth that or not, that's for you to decide. But them trying to get the water out of the hillside, it's supposed to rain for 4 more days this week too, guys. So this is just the beginning of this. And, you know, share your thoughts on this stuff. You know, there's a apartment complex in San Clemente that's going down, but this is just the beginning of this.
That's amazing, guys. That's shocking, those poor people. But it's gonna rain all week long too. We're gonna have 4 days of rain too. Matthew Kinnerman and Michael Killingsworth are two economists. One's a Princeton professor, one's a Nobel Prize winner. He did a study and asked the question, does money buy happiness? And he said, not really, but here's what it does buy. It buys peace of mind. Not being in debt is, you know, is liberating. It's freedom. It gives people peace of mind when they live their life. They sleep better at night. They feel healthier. They feel better not having the wolves at the door beating down the door for, you know, bill collectors. So that's what people need to look at. People need to look at things like that as far as getting themselves out of debt. You know, talk to a financial advisor. People have written me so much about their 401ks. I can't give you financial advice because I'm not a financial advisor, but you need to get the answers from these people on what you should be doing right now, because this is a pivotal point in history right now when it comes to all this money. It really is. The banks are a mess right now, guys. We've seen the mortgage industry go completely upside down to where it's basically non-existent, but the realtors want to tell us that the home industry is good. And Lennar wants to say, hey, everything's looking up. No way. No way, Jose. It's just off, guys. And you're seeing interest rates are going to go up this week. A quarter of a point, at least. Well, things are going to go up. So many people have written me about their credit cards. I mean, you know, Dan, I started to open those things and look at it. And I looked at the email and called my credit card company, called Chase, and said, I want to get on paper statements again. And they did everything they could to talk me out of it. But Bank of America, Chase, all these different banks are raising interest rates substantially right now. 5%, 8%. You know, it's a lot of money, guys. It really is. So, also wanted to give you guys another update from a story I did a couple weeks ago. So I went to the city of Orange. Take a look at this. Do you guys remember 2 weeks ago when I was at the Orange Circle? Well, they closed off the center fountain, that beautiful fountain that everybody sat out at, everybody had a good time at, and they were going to remodel this area, but some kid was evading the police, high on grass and God knows what, and he ran down the street here, right here, and then ran into the fountain. Isn't that great? How awesome is that? So he got arrested for that. And I just thought I'd do a little follow-up and drive over here and show you guys. So the whole area is closed off now, okay? So one dope addict ruined it for everybody. Isn't that crazy? So just stay away from drugs, kids, okay? My public service announcement for the day. I'm going to end this video on these last couple stories. And first things first is the Fed is panicking right now, guys. There's a story below about how the Fed is going to ease cash into banks right now so that they don't collapse right now, which is horrible. Absolutely ridiculous. And they're going to pump cash into these banks and solidify them and make it look like they have money so you can pull it out. So you can follow Dan's advice and make sure you have your cash, because they don't have the cash in these banks. Fractional banking means that they had to have less and less money in the account to equal the deposits that they had on record. Well, eventually got to zero right now, guys. So look at things like gold. Look at things like silver, look platinum, look at uranium, look at Bitcoin, look at whatever you want, but make sure you're into something. And again, all you Bitcoin clowns that are writing me, telling me how great it is and how I missed this spike, tell me, number one, how much you own. I don't care that you own $60 worth of Bitcoin. That means nothing. Why don't you say, Dan, I bought it here, because I know a guy that bought it at $300 and had it in FTX and pulled it out of FTX, and it was worth a ton, that he should be sitting on a beach if he had any sense. But that's that. So the Fed is pumping money into these banks to make sure that they look like they're open. you're seeing such a problem. When I was in Las Vegas, I was shocked at the businesses that said, we're only open at the walk-up window. We have no staff to work on the inside of this place. Still, it's like that, okay? Yukon Harvest, which is a homeless shelter that gives people food. Missy King is one of the employees I interviewed for this, and the link is below. Reason why I'm telling you this is because the economy is so good, but the Yukon Harvest shelter and food bank went from serving 200 people a week to 700 people a week right now, guys, because people don't have jobs, people don't have food, people don't have money. So this is the beginning of this, and there will be more of this to come in the future. You're going to see that. So, you know, we've talked a lot about Fran Glover. We've talked a lot about people that have it difficult. Be kind to people, guys, right now. So many people are struggling. Reach out to your friends. Reach out to people you haven't talked to in a long time and just check in on them. Make sure they're okay, okay? Be helpful. Final thing is a guy on Reddit showed his exit paperwork for his company, and he basically took a template for how to quit your job and just basically scratched it out and wrote the company information in there. And it was up on Reddit for a while, and they eventually took it down. But again, guys, I love stories of how people quit their job, and you know, the friends will freak out, people will yell and scream. Tell me your epic story of how you quit your job, because I love it, you know? I have quit a few jobs in my day. The older I get, the funnier the stories are, you know? And I can tell people that stuff. So don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, take a look at the sponsor, and don't forget to join the email list, guys. Onward and Upward, we're gonna have a crazy, crazy week this week. So share your thoughts. Don't forget to email me, hello@iAllegedly.com. And I will see you guys very soon.